Hi everyone and welcome. In this video we are going to configure and test a high availability cluster in vSphere. One of the first things I'm going to do is add some redundancy into my management network, which is something that is definitely best practice for high availability clusters. I already configured ESXi02, so I'll just do one. I've selected my cluster, go into configure, and select virtual switches. What I'm going to do right now, management traffic is running on my management network, and I'm going to add that into the vMotion network. Expand out my vSwitch 3, and I'm going to edit my kernel port and select the management checkbox. And that's all I need to do to have management traffic running on both of the management network and on my vMotion network. What that's going to do is allow the heartbeats necessary between the hosts on the high availability cluster to communicate both on the management network and what's traditionally the vMotion network. Next thing I'm going to do is create the cluster itself, which is a pretty simple thing to do. Right click on my data center, say I want a new cluster, have to give it a name. I'm going to call it in-class 8530CL, specify that I want high availability, just turn that on, and click OK, and I am done. The cluster is now configured, as we can see here. The only thing we have to do is add the hosts into the cluster, and that's also equally as easy. I'm just going to take the host, drag it on top of the cluster. We'll see that a task has now been started to add the host to the cluster. And I'm going to wait for that one to finish. And once it is, I'll add the second host into the cluster. Once that's done, we'll have high availability running, which will protect any VMs running on any of the hosts that are part of the cluster. Okay, ESXi host 01 is now in the cluster. That's complete. We can see that the host up here is indented inside of the cluster object. I'm going to do the same thing with my second host to add that into the cluster. Again, we'll see that task started, and once that's finished, we will have the cluster complete with two hosts. Okay, that task is complete. If I go back and select on my cluster, we can see an error on that right now, which is simply there because we only had one host in it initially. I can select my hosts and see that there are two hosts that are located in my cluster. I can look at what VMs are in my cluster, and I can see my Linux VM here. Okay, I want to go back and look at a couple pieces of information now that the cluster's formed. If I go in the monitor, I'm going to select summary from high availability, and we'll see that we have a master host, that's ESXi01, since it was first one in. We have one other host connected to the master, that will be ESXi02. And along with that, we have one protected virtual machine. That means that if one of the hosts fails, the virtual machine will fail over onto the surviving host in our case. We're going to test that, and what we're going to do is simulate a failure by shutting down ESXi02. I'm going to right-click on this guy, go into power, and then shut down. I'm not going to put it in standby mode first because that would cause it to evacuate the VMs, which I don't want to do. And say that we're going to test HA and OK, which will now shut down the host. And we'll monitor any of the events that are taking place. At this point in time, I'll have to refresh this manually. But eventually we'll see that the cluster will acknowledge that it no longer has access to the host. It'll think the host is dead and the VM will come up on the other host. So here we have the error detecting that we have a host failure. We have a message that it's initiated an HA failover. Let me expand this column out a bit here. So it's telling us that for the virtual machine, it's initiated a failover. Process is taking place now. And once that's finished, which it looks like it is, this VM will now be running on ESXi01. And we can see that here looking at the information for the VM. Or, of course, we can go to ESXi01 and we can look at the VMs that are running on that and we can see our Linux VM. Once our other host comes back up, that's not going to fail back. It's going to stay on ESXi01, but that's a good illustration of failover for a virtual machine if we have a host failure when that virtual machine is protected in a high availability cluster. It's a wrap for the video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.